In terms of exposure for our program, it was great. We just last year we had an opportunity to play on TV several times. People got to see us play. Been all over the country recruiting, and people have asked about our basketball team because they've seen them play. And so the exposure has gotten better for our team. I think that has definitely helped recruiting. And it comes down to that. Everything we do is viewed through the prism of recruiting.
After last year's run to the NCAA tournament, there's been a ton of superlatives thrown their way. And while it would be easy to rest on their laurels, Nagy says the team has been anything but complacent.
I think we had a good summer. We had a good fall. Our kids lifted hard. They really pushed themselves and made good gains. But, you know, there have been some distractions, too, I think, with all of the hype of so many people returning and, you know, the preseason polls and all those things. Sometimes it's hard to, keep kids humble.
This is a veteran team, but the one graduating senior leaves an awful big void, the vocal leader and tough physical presence of Seneca, Illinois product Griffin Callahan.
We've not been a real physical team. We're much more finesse, but Griff always gave us that, and I just wonder now, who's going to fill that role for us? Because, you know, we're going to need some of that. We just are going to need that from guys. And I think Tavon will fill some of it, but we need other people to fill more roles of it and enjoy the contact.
It's hard to look up much about college basketball these days and not hear about senior guard Nate Walters. And with all the attention he's garnered, not only from the media, but also from the NBA, the St. Cloud native has stayed very well grounded.
He would prefer to just be in the gym playing basketball. I mean, that's what he wants to do, is play ball. He doesn't. And there's so many other things that go with that, particularly when you become a good player and have a reputation like he does. There are other things that go with it that he endures, but his main focus is just being in the gym.
All the attention may go Walters' way, but the unsung hero is the team's other senior, Madison, South Dakota native Tony Feakin.
He's probably going to have to be our Griffin this year in terms of his physicality. I mean, there's so many things he can do. He's versatile. He can guard people on the perimeter. He's our best post defender. And so we have to use him in a lot of different places. And his energy does get used up primarily on the defensive end. And, you know, secondary for him is going to be the scoring.
A challenging non-conference schedule opens up Friday when the Jacks play at Alabama, a game that will be nationally televised on ESPNU.
Certainly we'll go into that game with confidence. But they'll be ready for us. We're not sneaking up on these teams anymore. We've gotten too much exposure that way, and so I think that they'll be ready for us. I think every team we play will be ready for us, but the non-conference season is, and I was just looking at it this morning, is brutal. It really is, and they're all on the road. All of those games, I shouldn't say they're all on the road, because we do have Tennessee State in here, who's a very good basketball team, the only team to beat Murray State last year. But when you look at the teams that were in the NCAA tournament last year and were in postseason play last year, those games are on the road. And winning on the road, non-conference in particular, is very difficult.